here in St. Bernard Parish, Shell Beach, where they're loading all this boom onto boats to take out to try and stop the oil spill from hitting coastal parts of St. Bernard Parish. You can see behind me, they have thousands of feet of boom on the back of this truck. If you look at this one right here, this is about 100 feet of boom, so you can see how much they have here. They're loading it up. They're trying to take it out. They're trying to be proactive here and stop this oil from hitting coastal parts of St. Bernard Parish. But there are some concerns, and there could be some potential problems. We're joined by Ken Campo. This is all of your problem, all of your property here, but you tell us the wind could be a problem.
The wind's going to be the biggest factor in the whole thing. Is this will do good if we can get this wind to die down. You know, this stuff here is good in calm water. It don't work in rough water because the waves come over the top of it. I mean, what they want to do is lace the marsh with it, the outside of the marsh, to keep it from coming in the marsh, which will work if they can keep the waves down. Now, they're talking about Monday, the wind's going to go to the north, which will blow it offshore, which will blow this stuff back out into the Gulf. But as long as the wind stays out the east, southeast, south, it's going to blow it this way. But if it don't blow hard and get real rough, you know, this stuff will work. It'll keep the majority of it out of the marsh.
How big of a problem is this for all of the commercial fishermen down here, shrimpers, oystermen, people who make their career on these waters?
Put in simple words, it's a matter of life or death for them. Oyster fishermen, you know, oysters stay there. They can't move around. Once this oil hits them and kills them, there's nothing to replace them with. Where do you get oysters to replace them with from? And then if you do rebid everything, you're talking about 3 to 5 years before you can start harvesting. So as far as fish, fin fish and that's shut down anyway. But that and crabs, they can revive themselves. They can restock themselves. You know, they'll go out and they stay on the bottom. They'll go out and get in the front of this stuff. And when the water gets good, they'll come back. But oysters can't do that. Oyster fishermen will take the worst beating out of it because their product just sits there. And if this stuff gets in there and kills their oyster, then they got to go find some place that has good oysters to rebed them. And then you're talking about anywhere from 3 to 5 years before they can start harvesting.
Hopefully this will work. Ken Campo from Campo's Marina. Obviously, most people who are familiar with St. Bernard Parish know where Campo's Marina is here at Shell Beach. And take a look at this before we go once again. You can see the work continues. The wind, a problem, but they are loading thousands of feet of boom onto these boats, and they're taking it out near the marshlands here in St. Bernard Parish, trying to stop this oil from coming ashore, really doing damage to Louisiana's natural resources and the commercial fishing industry. Reporting on your side from Shell Beach, I'm Travers Mackle, WDSU News.